Hey guys, welcome to the Heat Transfer Fundamentals from Skill-Lync. Heat is the transfer of energy that occurs because of temperature difference. Say that you are holding on to a cup of hot tea. Here, heat is being transferred from the tea to your arm. That is why your palms feel warm. Similarly, if I place a block of ice on my arm, then heat is being transferred from my arm to the ice. This transferred heat raises the temperature of the ice, eventually melting it. Understanding how heat transfers gives you the power to control it. With this power, you can figure out how to heat or cool something efficiently. For example, take this vessel full of water. On high heat settings, it takes 10 minutes for the water to boil. Just by the basic understanding that conduction is faster than convection, I can introduce solid metal tubes inside the vessel to decrease the boiling time. Heat from the bottom of the vessel is conducted via the tubes and then convected to the fluid. With more tubes, we increase the area over which heat transfer occurs, and that is why the boiling time reduces. Now, there are three modes of heat transfer: conduction, convection, and radiation. Let us go through them. Conduction heat transfer occurs by the interaction of energy carriers. In gases, the energy carriers are molecules. In metals, electrons. The temperature of any material is a statistical quantity which is proportional to how these energy carriers vibrate. In a solid metal rod, if we heat one end, the electrons start to vibrate there and the vibrations transferred to the other end of the rod, thereby increasing the temperature over there. The speed at which the vibration travels depends on critical material properties such as thermal conductivity, specific heat, and density. The second mode of heat transfer that I want to talk about is radiation. Here, heat is transferred via electromagnetic waves. Let us say that it is a bright sunny day outside and the outside temperature is around 25 degrees Celsius. If you park your car outside with the windows closed and the AC turned off, you will notice that the cabin temperature starts to rise. This happens because of heat is being transferred from outside to the inside of the car. By the zeroth law of thermodynamics, the temperature in the cabin could increase only till 25 degrees Celsius, right? Because, you know, that is the outside temperature. But that is not what happens. The cabin temperature can get as high as 40 degrees Celsius in just under 30 minutes. This happens because of the radiation from the sun. Energy transfer to the car takes place by the penetration of electromagnetic waves. In fact, even today, engineers in automotive companies face the challenge of overheated car cabins. Heat is transferred not only by molecular vibration and radiation, but also because of bulk fluid motion. In this example, we have a tank being heated by a cup of hot water, and we place food color on the floor of the tank. Heat gradually transfers from the hot water to the tank and the water inside the tank. Hot water travels upwards and in this process transfers heat to the neighboring chunks of water. This can be noticed by the colors diffusing and forming a convection current. Now, we can speed up this convection process, which by the way is free convection, by using a small fan. This causes the mixing process to take place much quicker and thereby transferring heat efficiently. This process is what you would call as forced convection. All right. I hope you have learned about the different modes of heat transfer in this video, and we will see you in the next one. Bye.